This week, the man who represented Northeast Tennessee in the United States Congress for 15 years received the American Legion's highest honor. Josh Smith reports retired Congressman Phil Rowe was awarded the American Legion Distinguished Service Medal, joining the ranks for former presidents, war heroes, and icons like Bob Hope and Babe Ruth.
I was very honored and flattered, quite frankly. I said, you sure you got the right guy? And they said, yeah, we sure we got the right guys.
Phil Rowe, physician turned Johnson City mayor, turned United States congressman. But his path to the American Legion's highest honor began before all that, back in 1971, fresh out of medical school, drafted during the Vietnam War and sent to Korea.
There were three of us young doctors, three, to take care of an infantry division, which had over 10,000 men in it.
After the war, Rowe says he saw firsthand the struggles facing veterans and their families.
So if I ever had the opportunity, I would do something about that, and I did.
Right after he was elected to Congress, Rowe said he asked to be appointed to the House Veterans Affairs Committee.
And I said, the reason I want to be on there is because most of the things we deal with are medical. I said, I did some of my medical training. I'm a veteran. And much of the things we talk about are things that we'll need that I have an expertise in, so I want to be there on that committee.
Rowe eventually became chairman of the House Veterans Affairs Committee, facing big challenges within the VA.
There were 100,000 homeless veterans. 100,000 homeless veterans in the United States of America, a country this rich. There were 1 million backlog disability claims. I was flabbergasted by that.
During his chairmanship, the committee passed more than 50 veteran-specific bills, expanding medical and mental health care options, streamlining benefit appeals, and reforming the GI Bill.
You can use it the rest of your life. So if you're 45 years old and COVID took away your job or your company moved offshore or whatever, you can go back to school and use that benefit. You can also pass that benefit down to your children.
Rowe now works with groups like the Elizabeth Dole Foundation to support veterans' causes, a job he says will never end.
I'm going to do it till I die. So I'm going to be served. I'm going to serve those folks until I'm not here anymore.
In Johnson City, Josh Smith, News Channel 11.
Tell us about the veteran you know whose story needs to be told. Go to WJHL.com and click on the Community tab to nominate a veteran for our weekly Veterans Voices series.